What is the difference between censorship and erasure to you? And how do you think about reflecting the stakes of each in your work? Like, do you think there is a difference in those two things?
Yeah, I mean, I think that they have a relationship to each other that's temporal. It makes sense to me in sequence, in that in the moment that we're in right now, in Florida, if you can't say the word gay, or we can't read these books on our history, or drag is no longer legal in states or cities or whatever, that is a form of censorship that's happening right now in the present. But then 10 years from now, it results in the erasure, and it results in the lived experience that we don't, as queer and trans people and many other populations in the white Western world, don't have the privilege of continuity and coherence and an understanding of, oh, I come from this place, as, you know, we see in Desire Lines, like I can research and get to know the people that already did all of this thinking, so I don't have to, you know, like, and so to me, censorship and erasure are sort of inextricably linked, but it makes the most sense to me in sequence. And I think that as an artist, oftentimes we are, because I feel the same way about the language being like kind of off for me. In my work, I will confront erasure because I'm confronting the lived experience of being in this body in this moment, and it has already been erased. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. We're not yet in a moment where we've had generations of queer and trans people who've been able to build on each other's stories with a real robust sort of like economically supported, you know, system. Like, we're doing it DIY, but right. Then it gets erased over time. So that's, I'm sort of avoiding the question, or rather sort of shifting
okay.
the thing.
That's okay. You're allowed. Jules, you have something to say.
Oh, I feel like there's another piece of this that to me feels related, and feel free to shut it down if it doesn't feel related, but which is the idea of legibility. And that we, I don't know, anyone who's sort of marginalized and living under a context, under this idea about human rights, you have to make yourself into something or someone that is legible by those in power to even be seen, to then be erased. And I think that's incredibly violent, right? I have to use language that cis people understand and use to talk about gender in order to be understood. And I don't want to use that language. And, you know, obviously BIPOC folks are put in that position, all sorts of people who are outside of the dominant or mainstream, anyone in power, you are often required to use language that's not your own language to be recognized. And so the other thing that happens is those of us who refuse to do that then are not even captured on the historical record. And that is its own kind of, can be seen as its own kind of erasure, or it can be seen as a way of actually escaping the violence of the state. If they can't see you, they can't kill you, right? So.
No, Alok, we were talking about this yesterday. Alok, who is a film here, I'm sure most of you know who they are. They're amazing. Activist, writer, poet, performer, et cetera. They were educating me that it was only in 2016 that there was a legal definition of sex in order to then use that to weaponize it against trans people. And that before that, there was not a like agreed upon, and please correct me if I'm wrong, but this is what Alok was telling me yesterday, that there was not this agreed upon term that is in, you know, writing in the legal system, and it only came into existence so that they could then weaponize it against trans people. And so sort of this similar thing where it's like, okay, you become legible so that you can be prosecuted or oppressed, or you remain invisible and then you lose out on the ability to engage in the marketplace. And it's like we see over and over again, only the populations that have access to resources are the ones who are able to sort of do things at a mass scale. So yeah, you're kind of, it's like, where do you go?
Damned if you do, damned if you don't. Yeah.